Howdy y'all. This is Willem Pugmire. I'm here with my friend Ron. Ron and I were Mormon missionaries in Las Vegas in 1973. You were 19.
Yes.
And I was 21. And we have not seen each other in 40 years. And he's in town. Do you remember this?
He's pretty lucky.
Do you remember this?
No, I don't.
You and I bought a set of these each for our mother for Mother's Day in Vegas and send them to our moms.
Already?
Yeah. He doesn't remember much.
I don't.
Do you remember the talent show?
Yes.
Talent show. We had a talent show for the church. It was a stake talent show. You dressed up like a cowboy.
I always was a cowboy.
You always were a cowboy, dude. Yeah. Ron dressed up cowboy. He had these sunglasses on and you lip synced to Neil Diamond. A Neil Diamond record.
Yes.
And you remember what I did?
Weren't you singing Streisand?
I borrowed a wig and a muumuu from one of the sisters and put on some makeup. And I was a Mormon missionary in Las Vegas. This is before.
Scary.
This is before.
It was scary.
I was scary. And I lip-synced to Barbra Streisand. The only time I've done Barbra Streisand drag was when I was a Mormon missionary in Vegas. And that's way before I knew I was gay. Well, I kind of had an idea. But how everyone else didn't realize I was gay. Well, my President McConkie knew I was gay because he asked me.
So
did I. You knew I was gay?
Yeah, I was polite enough not to ask.
Well, cool. Well, I'm glad. I'm glad I was.
Well, I didn't know. I kind of figured.
You kind of figured.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So.
Matter of fact, I think I was the one that told President McConkie to check it out.
Yeah. He was.
Great.
He was a great guy. He was concerned because on our off day, when all the other elders, missionaries were playing baseball, I would dress up as Count Pugsley. My green vampire, and I would put on my vampire makeup and a hat and a wig, my fangs, and I would be a vampire while all the other guys were playing baseball and
basketball.
Yeah,
he'd go out in the apartment. Behind the apartment, there's a great big tree, and he'd stand up in the tree when the wind would blow.
I love
popular tree.
Yeah, I love trees. I love being in Vegas. Vegas, you might not realize there's a lot of Mormons in Vegas. Quite a few. And
we really like walking the strip late at night.
We weren't supposed to do that. Missionaries, you know, you did too?
I didn't walk the strip and drag.
Oh, I didn't walk it and drag.
And
I only
did.
We would sneak out at night and cross the railroad tracks and walk to the strip. We did it a couple times.
And then sneak. We just went.
We just went.
We weren't sneaking.
Well, but we weren't supposed to be doing it, dude. We were bad boys. We were bad boys. I was a very rebellious missionary. And it's a miracle that I lasted 2 years. I began my mission in Ireland. And then I faked that I was dying of emphysema. And I thought that would... Because I wanted to go home. I didn't want to be a missionary anymore. So instead of sending me home, they sent me to the desert to dry out my lungs that I said were infected with emphysema and stuff. So that's how I ended up in Tucson and Las Vegas. But I enjoyed Las Vegas.
Las Vegas was a protective area.
Yeah. And there was one of the members owned a fried chicken joint, and the missionaries were able to eat there for free. So I think we'd go every other week and have free fried chicken. Remember that?
Not the chicken joint. I remember that Don W. Ashworth, who gave us our apartment was behind his house. Him and McConkie graduated with honors.
Uh-huh.
His dad owned the Golden Nugget. We ate there every other week free.
Oh, I don't remember that.
Yeah, it was the Golden Nugget where we ate for free. His dad owned it, and I think he's got it now. He was the one that gave us the vet that we drove.
Yeah, which
Remember the vet.
I remember it. I don't remember us driving it though. But yeah, we lived in the guest house. It had a it was great. It had a sunken bathtub and it was real posh.
Velvet couches, yeah. He made it nice for the missionaries.
We were
the first elders to move into it.
We were. Yeah. That was 40 years ago. So I haven't reconnected with many of my old missionary buddies, my companions. We were together, how long we were together? 3 months?
I think longer than that.
Yeah?
Well, I was in Vegas about 6 months, so, and you were there with me most of the time, so I was probably 4 or 5. We were
okay,
together.
All right. Almost half a year then. It was great. We had great members, and they put up with a lot.
Used to come home and there'd be bags of groceries at our door.
Remember that?
There'd be bags of groceries at our door all the time when we'd come home, and they gave us a lot of referrals. One time we
forgot our key and we had to break the glass of the door. Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So.
That's when Brother Ashworth was on vacation. Couldn't get us in.
Right. Yeah.
Remember what we did to his garden?
No.
Oh man, where were you?
What did we do with his garden?
Remember he was trying to grow a garden, and that soil wouldn't grow a garden. Remember he left, and when he first got there, the house wasn't finished, and I helped, I don't know what you did, carpet the house and get the house ready while he was gone on vacation. At the same time, he was trying to grow a garden. So remember we went out and bought cantaloupes and watermelons and cans of corn. We tied cans of corn to his corn stalks.
I don't remember that at all.
And we put big watermelons and stuff where he had nothing because it was so dry and his ground was so dead. I told him he could never grow anything because I farmed from Utah. So we went and bought cans of different vegetables and tied them where they're supposed to be and stuff like that. And when he came home, when he got home from vacation and that morning, he woke us up early back there screaming, "You don't see my garden, how it's grown." He had all this food and it was pre-canned and... You don't remember doing that?
I
with
don't.
Ash.
Dude, it was 40 years ago. 40
that
years
was
ago.
That was
well,
the neatest
I remember,
time of my entire mission was Ashworth.
Yeah, I remember we found a stray dog, a stray puppy dog, at one of the baseball games, and I brought it home. And
he was a stray bringing a stray home.
I was, yeah. Oh, it was good. Didn't have any baptisms. Well, we didn't know we did. We had one baptism. Yeah, we had one baptism. Yeah. And then where were you transferred to after that?
From there, I think I was close to my mission there. I think that's when I went into Thatcher, into the I got to go to the institute there in Thatcher, Eastern Arizona College. I know that's where I ended, and I thought that was my next move was to Thatcher, was from there to Thatcher. But I was in the same area in Tucson twice. I was in Blythe, California. I was in Glendale, Las Vegas, and Thatcher.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I ended my mission in Tucson. And it was, for a Seattle boy, it was difficult getting used to that weather and having to ride our bicycles in desert heat. Now, Ron is mayor of Providence, Utah. And when I heard that, it was... You all know, the word Providence is special to me because of H.P. Lovecraft, who lived in Providence, Rhode Island. So when I haven't hooked up with many of my old missionary companions, but... Now and then I would do a search, Google search on Ron. And so a few weeks ago I did another one and I found the mayor of Providence, Utah, Ron Lichty, and the mayor had a email address, so I sent him an email and supplied. I had one picture of us together with the what's it called? A vet?
Corvette.
Corvette. And just on the chance that that was him, and that was you. And now, what brings you to the Northwest?
Well, I was when you sent me the email, I was online. I recruit for Schlumberger, who's the biggest, one of the biggest in the natural gas and oil field that well services. And I travel all over Washington. Well, I just started traveling Washington, but I've traveled Oregon and Utah and Wyoming and northern Idaho and Montana. And I find recruits to hire to go, guys to go to work in the oil field. And I was on the line answering a couple of things from Schlumberger, and this little email popped up, and I seen this guy up in the corner, and then I seen this Corvette and me, and I said, I gotta go, and hung up. You gotta be kidding me, that can't be what I think that is, and that's how you caught me.
Yeah.
So my wife's moved up here. She runs laboratories, and she's taken a big job at a hospital in Vancouver, Washington. We found a little apartment, so we're looking at moving this way. Well, we've moved her, and I'm trying to see if I'm selling the house, because I've got a recruit down there still, so we're just trying to decide what to do, so I go back and forth all the time, and I recruit up here now.
Yeah, so so it's pretty amazing to me, after 40 years, to hook up with one of my missionary companions. And
his best companion.
Yeah, you were my favorite companion. You put up with a lot of crap from me. But we did
work hard.
We
had some fun, but we worked hard.
We were good elders.
Mm-hmm.
And it was, you know, when I began my mission, you know, of course I was raised a Mormon, but I wasn't really, you know, I had never really read the Book of Mormon and all that kind of stuff, and I didn't really have a testimony until I found myself in Ireland having to preach the stuff. And that kind of gave me a testimony. And it was my experience as a missionary, because I left the church for 25 years when I came out as queer. And
gay.
I, huh?
Gay.
No, I'm political, so the word is queer.
Wow.
It's like the N-word. Black people take the N-word and they turn it into a tribal declaration of identity, in positive identity. And so, but even though it's supposed to have negative connotations, so instead of calling myself a gay man, I call myself queer, as kind of like, because I'm rebellious, like I was back then, and because it's a word that is frowned on. And it's supposed to be disrespectful. I use it as a badge of, you know, identity and honor. You're not a rebellious guy, so you don't understand this mindset. It's the same thing
as far
where it's the same thing that
as far
that,
as you know.
Well, you were a wanker, but she doesn't know that. He doesn't know what that means, do you?
No.
Okay, cool. Smart ass.
Oh, well, yeah, that's
yeah, true. You were a smart ass. But you kept me in line. And but it was being a missionary that kind of, even though I was excommunicated, I left the church, I was rebellious, I was a drag queen, I was a street transvestite, punk rock up the ass. I was rebellious. There was always a Mormon spark in me, and it was because of that missionary experience that I eventually returned to the church, because two guys knocked on my door and I let them teach me the discussions, and that led to my return to the church and my rebaptism in 2002. Anyway, we're gonna go. I have a breakfast group that meets every Sunday, so we're gonna go have breakfast with a bunch of people. Don't know how many people are going to be there. A lot of people aren't coming this week for some reason, so they're going to miss out on this charming fellow.
It's because I'm there and they're nervous.
They are nervous. They thought that Ron didn't know I was gay, and that he was going to find out at the breakfast, and it might be uncomfortable for him. But I'm not wearing. You can see I'm not wearing any makeup. I was tempted to put on my Boy George face, but I thought I didn't want to stun you
You wouldn't.
with my deviance.
He wouldn't have.
Because you're the mayor of, you're a mayor in Utah, dude. It's like, are you still active in the church?
Of course.
Yeah, cool.
Absolutely.
Absolutely, good. All right.
I should be in church today.
Yeah, so should I. I was going to go to church today. I missed out a couple of weeks, but anyway, we can always.
I'm the ward mission leader in our ward now.
Really? Coolness. All right. See, I am not yet. I don't hold the priesthood yet, and I can't go to the temple. I need to have a restoration of all blessings. And but just to be able, just to have been rebaptized, to be able to take the sacrament, and you know, it's cool. I love it.
Where do you need to be?
I love being a Mormon. So, all right, we're gonna go have breakfast with a bunch of cool people. So we all, I will see you later. Really glad you came and that we hooked up. This is really cool for me. It's very special. So,
Good to be here.
see you all later. Shalom.